Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Hope all of you are fine and safe. Today, I will discuss about different question answers from chapter 8, from exercise and outside. So, open your book, page number 83. At first, there is fill in the blanks. The solution of water and speed is a, what will be the appropriate word here? Yes, aqueous solution. Dash is an universal solvent. You know, water is an universal solvent. In a solution, the quantity of solute remains less and the quantity of solvent remains more. There is wrong spelling. There will be quantity. Milk and fog are colloids. Now MCQ questions. Which one is liquid gas solution? Here answer will be soft drinks, because you know that soft drinks actually the mixture of carbon dioxide gas and water. So this is liquid gas solution. And others examples are lemon juice, liquid, vinegar, also liquid solution, and saline water, solid liquid solution. Now, second question, which one is a colloid? Here, follow the options, chalk powder and water. This is not colloid, this is suspension. Flour and water, this is also suspension. Soil and water, this is also suspension. Fat and water. This is colloid because fat and water actually milk. Inside the milk, fat are dispersed in water. So this is colloid substance. Question. At room temperature, the solubility of sodium carbonate is 21.6 gram. What amount of sodium carbonate is required to make a saturated solution of sodium carbonate in 200 gram of water? That means this is a math of solubility. Here is given solubility and also amount of solvent. You have to determine here amount of solute. So there is given solubility is 21.6. So you have to determine the amount of solute. So you know the process, how will you determine the amount of solute. So in 100 gram there is present 21.6 gram sodium carbonate. Out of 1 how many and out of 200 gram how many? Actually answer will be here 43.2 gram. So inside the options there is not present correct answer. Here is 4.32, so I think it will be 43.2 gram. So also you will do correction here. Now follow the next page. If the quantity of sodium carbonate is 10 gram less, then the solution is obviously unsaturated, because there is said it is saturated solution. So if the amount of solute is less there, then that will be unsaturated solution. Now short answer questions. What is called solution? What is the main difference between solution and mixture? You know the answer. And what is the main difference between solution and mixture? This is actually not proper question, because solution is also one kind of mixture. Solution is a homogeneous mixture and other types is heterogeneous mixture. So this question is not actually appropriate here. What does it mean by solubility? You know what does liquid gas solution mean? Also you know the answer. What is called suspension? I have discussed in my last lecture. Are the colloid and suspension same? Give reasons in favor of your answer. No, you know very well from my last lecture, the colloid and suspension are not actually same. Okay, let's see the creative questions which are given in exercise. Priyanti and Rupanti were enjoying when they got down to the sea water at Cox's Bazar. Suddenly the water sea entered into the you have will read the step properly. Now come to the question. What is mixture? Why is water called universal solvent? You know the answer. शो बाय ड्रॉइंग अ स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम द प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस ऑफ द कंपोनेंट शोड बाय प्रियंती टू रूपंती. हेयर एक्चुअली प्रियंती शोन क्रिस्टलाइजेशन प्रोसेस टू रूपंती ऑफ सॉल्ट, हाउ सॉल्ट इज प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम सलाइन वाटर. सो यू हैव टू ड्रॉ हेयर पिक्चर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन प्रोसेस. जस्ट हेयर यू हैव टू ड्रॉ इलेबोरेटली द डायग्राम और पिक्चर ऑफ और फिगर ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइजेशन प्रोसेस एंड लेबल इट properly. No need to write the explanation, just you have to write nicely and properly with label the figure of crystallization process. And D number, analyze that both the components of the solution is possible to separate to obtain again. Yes, that means the question is how can you obtain the salt and water separately from the salt water solution. So by distillation process we will obtain both salt and water separately. So here in D number question you have to explain the distillation process elaborately, explain with figure. Here you have to also give the figure, draw the figure. Now come to the second question. When Adil was giving some medicine to his mother to take by mouth, he observed that his mother shakes the bottle every time before use, but at the time of drinking meal she does not shake. Okay, what is heterogeneous mixture? You know, what does it mean by solubility? So you know also the answer. Explain why Adil mother shakes the bottle of medicine. You know the answer also, because in last lecture I have discussed about this. Here antacid, she taken antacid syrup. So here actually medicine, antacid medicine is suspension type picture. And why do we shake suspension? I have discussed in last lecture. And the question, are the mixtures, both mixtures of same, give reasons. That means antacid and medicine, mouth, medicine to his mother to take. Okay, that means you have to explain suspension medicine and milk, are they same or not? Obviously not same, because one is suspension and another is colloid. Milk is colloidal, and also you can easily explain this from my last lecture. So these are the questions which are actually represented in your exercise. I hope you can easily give the answer. Now we will see some extra questions, creative questions. Follow here. One day PI is making a mixture by mixing sugar in water, and DI is making a mixture by mixing sand in water. What is colloid? What do you mean by distillation process? Explain. Just you have to explain the distillation definition with distillation process. Compare the above two mixtures. That means compare the mixture of sugar in water and sand in water. Here sugar water is a homogeneous mixture and sand in water is a heterogeneous mixture. So actually you have to write the comparison between homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. But you have to give the heading as sugar water mixture and sand water mixture. Not you will write directly homogeneous mixture, heterogeneous mixture. It will be 1 point of your answer. Will they follow same processes to separate both components easily from their mixture? No, because to separate sand water mixture, we can easily use separate them by using filtration process. And whereas to separate sugar from water, we can use evaporation, distillation, anyone. But evaporation will be easy. Actually, my dear students, in separation you have to remember that by how much easy way you can separate the components, you should follow that process, because we can separate the components in many processes, but which one will be easiest way, and not only easiest, which one will be in less cost. That means our separation cost will be very less. That processes we should follow. So in this sense, from sand water to separate sand water, we will use filtration process, and from separate sugar water we use evaporation process. So this is the actually logic that we have to use the easiest process and low cost process. Now for the next creative questions. Now what is aqueous solution? So aqueous solution, you know, when the in solution water is used as solvent, that is called aqueous solution. How can you convert saturated solution into unsaturated solution? I have also discussed in my second lecture saturated solution into unsaturated solution, adding more amount of solvent and also applying heat. What is the solubility of the salt mentioned in the stem? That means there is a math, there is given a math, so you have to determine the solubility here. Very easy, I have discussed this in my second lecture. Water is a universal solvent. Already you have submitted your SW on this question. So these questions also you can solve easily. Now I have presented another creative questions. So also this is a important question. What is gas liquid solution? You know, in where gas liquid solution means in a solution where solvent is in liquid state and solute is present in gaseous state, that is called actually gas liquid solution. Why do you shake the antacid syrup before using? Also you know the answer. What type of solutions are made by Shima and Tama? For the step here, Shima made a solution mixing sugar, 5 spoon sugar in 1 glass of water. But same things done by Tama, but she used only 1 spoon. 1 spoon sugar in a 1 spoon sugar in a 1 glass of water. That means Shima used 5 spoon of sugar and Tama used 1 spoon of sugar in 1 glass of water. In this sense, you can say Shima made concentrated solution and Tama made diluted solution. But here one line is mentioned, that is some grains of sugar cannot be dissolved by vigorous stirring. For the presence of this line, you cannot directly write Shima made concentrated solution. Here you have to mention that Shima actually made a saturated solution, because you know that in case of saturated solution, some grains of solutes cannot be dissolved by vigorous stirring. So Shima made saturated solution, so Tama made unsaturated solution. But if this line is not mentioned here, so in this case directly you will write the answer as Shima made concentrated and Tama made diluted solution. But if this type of line is present in the stem, then you must write the first solution is a saturated solution and another solution is a unsaturated solution. Now explain the interconversion above the solution. That means you have to write the process, how can you convert saturated to unsaturated solution and unsaturated to saturated solution. Now another stem, what is solubility? You know, how can you convert concentrated solution to diluted, concentrated solution to diluted solution? Just adding of solvent. Here compare the above two mixtures. Here one mixture is sugar in water and another mixture is sand, salt and iron. Very good. Here actually this is a homogeneous mixture, sugar water, and this is a heterogeneous mixture. So we have to compare homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture. But heading must be sugar water mixture and sand salt iron mixture. How can you separate the components of the mixture of the okay? That means how can you component separate the mixture of sand, salt and iron? Explain with necessary figure. That means you have to also draw the diagram. So how can we separate sand, salt and iron? Since there is present iron and salt also, so at first from the mixture sand, salt, iron, use magnet we will separate iron from the mixture of sand, salt and iron. So when we rub the iron on the near on the mixture, then all iron particles will be separated. Rub the magnet on the near of the mixture, then all iron particles are separated from the mixture. Then we shall leave sand and salt. Now we will add some water in the mixture, then salt particles will be dissolved in that water and sand particle will not be dissolved. Then we will use filtration process. Through filtration process, we can successfully separate the sand particles from the salt water solution. So iron is already separated, sand is also separated. Now which one is remains salt, but in water. So we will do evaporation process. If we follow evaporation process, then all water will be evaporated and only salt particles will remain at the pot. Like this way, through the magnetization, filtration and also evaporation, we can separate sand, salt, iron separately and separate successfully. So like this way, you have to explain the magnetization with figure, then filtration with figure, then evaporation. But you will draw quickly, not elaborately, but you will draw roughly but nicely and also with label, and try to explain technically all the processes. So my dear students, like this way you have to explain the question answers for all question, this type of question. So today up to this, and it will work to you everybody, because Eid is our Eid al Adha is very coming soon. So everybody, I wish all of you Eid Mubarak, and inshallah we will meet in next. Thank you.